Are you looking for a solution to monitor and manage the Node-RED instances running on your Edge devices like Control-X Core, PLC Next, or Revolution Pi securely? If your answer is yes, this video is for you. In this video, we will see how to control and manage the Node-RED instance running on the Revolution Pi using FlowFuse. So let's imagine a scenario where you have three remote locations where your Edge devices are installed. On these Edge devices, Node-RED instances are running where user can interact with the dashboard. So let's say remote location 1 is using Control-X Core as an Edge device. Remote location 2 uses Revolution Pi as an Edge device, and remote location 3 uses PLC Next as an Edge device. Now our task is to monitor, manage, and control these Node-RED instances from our headquarters or main location like shown on the globe. So how do we do this? Let me introduce you FlowFuse. FlowFuse offers a platform where we can create a Node-RED instance running on the server. From this instance, we can connect to the remote Edge devices securely via device agent, and then we can deploy the snapshots to our device agents. Snapshot is basically a backup of Node-RED instance. This workflow makes it super easy to manage remote Edge devices. So let's see how we can do that. First step is to create Node-RED instance on FlowFuse. You can sign up for free to test the FlowFuse platform. As I have already signed up, I will just sign in with my username and password. Now, once I am signed in, you see that I have a default application with my name. Inside this application, I can create instances. Let's add a new instance. Click on Add Instance. Here I can define the name of the instance. I will select small as my type and Node-RED 3.1.0 as my stack. You can also select any of the pre-built flows for your project, but for this video, let's select a blank workspace. Lastly, click on Create Instance. Now it will take a couple of seconds to start the instance. Meanwhile it starts, I can also click on the instance and see more details. Here you can see the specification of your instance. Let's wait a few more seconds. So finally, the instance is running. Let's click on this editor link to access the Node-RED editor. In this editor, we can make some flows. So you can see there are a couple of default nodes already available to use. For this video, I am going to use some demo flows that I created before. So let me just import my flow. Now because my flow has some dashboard and random nodes, I have to install that manually. Let me do that real quick. Let's finally deploy and open the dashboard. There you go, this is my sample dashboard which I will use for this video. Here you can see, I have a slider for set point which is being monitored using this gauge, and the chart below shows the history. Now the next step is to deploy this dashboard to the remote Edge device, which is Revolution Pi. To do that, we need to first add a new device in our instance and give it a name, Revolution Pi, and type as Edge. Once we define a new device, we get the device configuration file, which has all the credentials required to connect to the remote device. We can download this file for our reference. Now the next step is to set up the Edge device with FlowFuse Agent. This means we have to install FlowFuse Agent on the Revolution Pi. There could be several ways to do that. You can either do that directly on your Revolution Pi or connect via PuTTY. So I am going to use PuTTY software, so let's connect and enter our credentials. Now we are inside our Edge device. So to install the FlowFuse agent, I need to use this command. This will install the required device agent. Now the agent has been installed. Now I have to make a folder by using this command. So this command is creating a new directory named FlowForge device in the opt directory. Now I'm going to use another command, which will give me the ownership of using the directory. All right, great. Now let's navigate to our root directory by typing cd space forward slash. Let's check the content of the root directory. Before I continue, let me switch to the super user to make sure everything works great. Let's go inside the op directory, and then we have to go inside FlowForge device directory. Finally, we have to create a file named device.yml. For that, I can use a command nano followed by the file name. This will open up an editor in the terminal window. Now we can just copy paste the content of the configuration file that we have previously downloaded from the server instance. Let's save our file by hitting Ctrl X on your keyboard, followed by the key Y, and then press Enter. Now the device agent has been installed and ready to start. We can run our device agent using this command. For this demo, we are running the agent using PuTTY, but we highly recommend that you should run the agent directly from your Edge device. And kindly make sure your Edge device, which is Revolution Pi, in our case, has the access to the internet. Let's verify the status of our Edge device in our server instance by refreshing our page. Looks great. So you can see the status of our device. Now we are ready to deploy our first snapshot, which is basically the code in our instance, to our remote Edge device. To do that, let's navigate to instances and then snapshots. And let's create a new snapshot. I will give it a name, dashboard version 1, and set it as target. Now the snapshot has been successfully created, which has the backup of our Node-RED server instance. Now let's connect our Edge device to our instance that we created before. Here we can select our application and the respected instance. Now the device has been assigned to the instance. Now this will take several seconds for server instance to start the Edge device with the snapshot. Let's refresh the device page to check the status. All right, great. Now the Edge device is running with the server instance, and you can see the status here. You can also see the deployed snapshot status here. So let's verify by opening the dashboard of our Edge device. Looks perfect. So this is how you can deploy the instance to your remote agent. Now let's imagine, after a few weeks, our engineers at the remote location wants to visualize some analytics. In this case, the conventional way would be to take backup from the remote location and modify the code in your office, send it back to the remote location, and help them to upload it to their system. This might take hours. Depends on several factors. Now, using FlowFuse, you can do that in a fraction of seconds. You can just open up the instance. I am going to use the code that I tested before, so let me just import that in this flow. Let's deploy. I think I need to update the node location again. Let me do that real quick. Now you can see the analytics of our setpoint parameter. This is just an example. You can imagine any updates for your dashboard. Now to deploy this updated dashboard to the remote Edge device, which is Revolution Pi, we just need to create a snapshot. That's it. So let's call this new snapshot dashboard with analytics and set it as target. Let's go to device page to see the status. Looks great. Now you can see our remote device has been updated automatically with the new snapshot. Let's verify that real quick. Now our Revolution Pi dashboard is updated with the analytics. So we have seen how using these amazing snapshots, you can quickly update the remote Edge devices in a fraction of seconds. Interestingly, we can anytime select the old snapshot as target to our Edge devices. This is a great feature which helps in troubleshooting. Now you can see that the remote device has been deployed with the old snapshot that we created before. Another amazing feature of FlowFuse is that you can also access the editor of your remote device directly from your server. You just have to navigate to your device, activate the developer mode, which is disabled by default, and then enable the editor access. And now you can access the editor directly and make changes if required. This is a great help in debugging the flows of remote devices without using any external software. How cool is that? Furthermore, you can check out the audit logs for list of your activities, Node-RED logs, to check the status of your flow, and instance settings, which has all the instance details. So this is how FlowFuse makes it super easy to manage the remote edge devices. In this video, we have seen only one device, but you can add as many devices as you want in your instance. You can also create multiple instances and link that to the edge devices independently. This is not the end. There are many more amazing features of FlowFuse, for which I leave it for the next video. In the meantime, you can check out the documentation of FlowFuse to learn more. If you want to play around with FlowFuse, then sign up now to access the trial version by visiting this link. Thank you for watching this video. I will see you soon in the next video.